Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Sameeha Daredia. We have created programs using ordinary variables. These variables store single pieces of data, and they're not as useful. However, when we want to store a bunch of values such as to-do lists, student names, or high scores, we can use lists. For example, if you want to store 10 student names, then you'll need 10 variables, and for 20, you'll need 20 variables. Writing and maintaining a program with 10 or 20 variables would be tedious. In this video, we'll explore another built-in data type called lists. Let's go. Let's create a list to store the names of students. Creating lists is pretty similar to creating variables. Click this button to make a list. Like variables, lists can be made as global lists or local lists, but we're going to make a global list and name it students and hit OK. Here at the top, we can see the name of the list displayed, students, and here we can see the length. It's 0 as our list is empty. We can add items to our list by clicking this plus sign. And here you can see the length has increased. And we can delete by this X sign. In these spaces, we can type our values. We can also move our list and resize it. Here in full screen, we cannot move our list, nor can we resize or add items. Now let's check blocks for the list. Most of the times at the start of a program, that's when green flag is clicked, we set variables to 0. For lists, we delete all the values by using this block. As you can see now, our list is empty, the length is 0. We use this block to add values to our list. Let's add some student names. Anne, Ben, Tom, I've added Suzanne twice, and Joe. This block adds a new value at the end of the list. To insert a value at a specific index, we use this insert block. Let's insert rows at index 5. To do that, in this first parameter, we type rows. And in the second one, we type our index, which is 5. And click it. Now you see that rows is at index 5 and the indexes of the values below it have been changed. To replace any value, we use this replace block. Let's say we want to replace rows with Rosie. So rows is at index 5, so we want to replace the item at the index 5 with Rosie. So I'm just going to type Rosie here. And once I click it, we can notice that Rose has been changed to Rosie. Here I've added Suzanne twice. To delete one, we'll use this delete block. Here we'll specify the index of the value we want to be deleted. Let's say I want to delete Suzanne at the index 6. I'll just type in 6 here. And once I click it, we notice that the value Suzanne has been deleted at that specified index. So far we've seen how to add, insert, replace, and delete. Now let's see how to retrieve values from the list. For that we use this item 1 of students block, students, which is our list. This will retrieve the value at the specified index. Let's see what happens when I enter 11. It returns nothing, which is blank because we don't have a value at the specified index. When I enter 4, it returns Suzanne. This block will return the index of the value specified. For example, if I enter Suzanne, it gives me 4. Now, lists in Scratch 3 are not case sensitive. I can enter Tom in all capital letters. Sorry. I can enter Tom in all capital letters, and it will still return the index as 3. Now, if our list has a duplicate value, this block will always return the index of the first matching value. For example, I can use this block and add Suzanne once more. And once I type Suzanne here and click it, it still gives me 4 when we have Suzanne at 7 as well. This returns the length of the list, which is also visible below here. My list contains 7 items, so it returns 7. Very basic, nothing much about it. Let's move on to the next block, which is our conditional block. Now, this block returns a Boolean value, which is true or false. For example, in this space, if I enter Joe, it gives me true because our list contains Joe. If I enter Zoe, it should give me false because our list does not have Zoe. Next, we have these very basic blocks, show list and hide list. They do what they say, hide hides the list and show displays it on the screen. We can also export the content of our list into a text file. Just right click and select export. Select the folder you want it to export to. Okay, it's downloading. Now let's open the folder. Here we have our text file. We can also edit the content from here. I'm just gonna replace the Suzanne with Zen. And I'm going to replace this one with just save it. If you want to import that file into Scratch, right click, select import, and select the file you want to import. As you might have seen, importing the text file to our list has replaced all the values. And oh, I forgot to mention, the limit of lists in Scratch 3 is 200,000, which is more than enough for us. Thank you for watching till the end. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, turn on the post notifications, like this video, and if you have any suggestions, please leave them in the comment section down below. Also, follow me on my Insta at Sameeha Daredia. And don't forget to watch my other videos. Learn, code, and share. Bye-bye. Thank you.